Hi, so where we left off at in the last lesson was we created a boundary volume from a set of setback planes, which looked like this, and which defined the area where we could build in a given site. Then we created a series of levels that would correspond to the heights of given certain floor plates. We created three at a height of 4.5 and 16 with a height of 3.5 meters. Now we cut those floor plates from the volume, eliminated the ones that were below a minimum area, and we used that to calculate the total area that we could build from these floor plates. And then the yield, which was the total area divided by the area of the site. Now this is a very quick analysis of what can be built, but now we want to find a way of analyzing what we want to build. So that involves finding a way of sketching out floor plans in Rhino and putting them into Grasshopper to analyze. So we could just close this for a minute and say that we have, for example, a core. And we want to create a residential floor plan for the upper levels. What I've done is I've already sketched this in, but the important thing is, how do we make Grasshopper read our sketch and then analyze and get important data from it? So what I did is I created a base layer called Plan 01, which has four sublayers. One called floor plate, one called subdivisions, one called non-saleable, and one called void. And that should be enough to sketch all the information that we need for a very basic analytical plan, which can go into Grasshopper. So if we look at what I've already sketched, the first layer shows the outline of the floor plate. We've made it stick to the setbacks most everywhere except this indentation, where we don't want the apartments here to be too deep. Then the non-saleable layer basically is an outline that defines where the corridors are and where the circulation is, basically everything that can't be sold. Next are subdivisions for our different apartments. This is going to be important when we want to quantify the apartment types and their square meters. And finally, just for the sake of this exercise, even though it's a bit silly, added a void here. So this is a very basic sketch of a plan, and we want to put this into Grasshopper and have it become a part of our analytical model. So the way we're going to do this is first create a geometry pipeline component. So that's going to take whatever layers here and import all of that geometry into Grasshopper. So the first one's going to be you have to double click the type of geometry you want to import. So I just double clicked curves and I should get one curve being imported, the only one that I sketched. So we'll make four of these. And name them according to our layers. So now all of that geometry is in here. But now we want to multiply these for each of the relevant levels, which would be the upper levels. The way that we're going to do this is assigning where in these areas where we input a number of levels along with their floor height, we also want to input an index. So for the first level, it's going to be 0. And for the upper levels, it's going to be 1. Now, what this is going to do is it's going to give us a key for selecting which sketches go into which floors. So it's very simple. What we want is just 3 zeros followed by 16 ones, because that's what the floor plates are. So that's just a very quick exercise in copying this. And instead of having this as the input data, having the index as the input data. So that gives us a series of numbers. However, we've also inserted a start of 0, which was useful for our floor heights, but it's not useful for our indices, so we'll just disconnect this. And so we get 3 zeros followed by 16 ones. Now for our residential floor plates, which are index 1, we want to eliminate them. I mean, we only want to keep them for levels that show an index of 1. So all we have to do is set a Boolean operator here that tests which of the levels is equal to 1. And then use that along with a duplicate component. To duplicate our input curves. Now you're going to want to graft this. So they'll be in separate branches. So now, this is going to give us empty branches for the first 3 levels. And it's going to place this curve on every subsequent branch. However, these are all still at 0 height. So I'll just eliminate the context here so we can see this more clearly. They're all placed here. So now we'll just move them to the correct height. We already calculated the floor heights, the list of floor heights, and that came from this component. So we just want to create vectors in Z with this input and graph them. Well, but before we do that, I think you can notice that here we've got 20 items, whereas here we've got 19. That's because we added this 0 here. This was in order to set a starting point of 0 and add floor heights. However, this gave us one more floor height vector than we need. So we just have to delete the very last item on this list. We'll do that by reversing the list, eliminating the first item, then reversing it again. And that should give us 19 vectors, which we'll graft to match the branches from here. and simply move all of these curves to those heights. So I'll just hide everything else here. So that's our upper levels taken care of. We could just duplicate this for each of the inputs, and that'll move them to the correct height and put them in the correct branches. So that's our upper levels. What about the lower levels, index 0? So we're just going to want to copy this entire section over. And instead of the input here being 1, we want it to be 0. And we'll change the name of the inputs, because at the moment it's importing plan 1. But actually, we haven't drawn a plan 0 yet. We only have information for plan for the upper floors. So let's just take this opportunity to sketch out a new floor plan for ground floors and the first and second floors. This is as easy as taking this and duplicating the layers. And yeah, we want to duplicate the objects as well, just as a starting point. And just name it plan 00. Change the names of all of these as well. We can just go one by one. So for the floor plate, say we want to mostly keep the setbacks, but we want to create an indentation along the sidewalk for a greater space at the access point. So that's our new floor plate for the first levels. That's for subdivisions. We don't want any apartment subdivisions because it's not going to be apartments. We're not going to have apartment corridors. So we're just going to draw a new circulation scheme here. Where this is going to be an apartment lobby, and this is going to be two shops. And voids, we're not going to have any voids. So now we have information for plan 0. And when we change this to 00 for all of these, then it'll begin to import the corresponding levels. Now these are empty levels, but it should be creating branches for them anyway. Now you can see that the first levels are plan 0 and the rest of the levels are plan 1. So let's just go back. However, the only problem now is that all of the branches are separate at the moment. So these components give you plan 1, and these components give you plan 0. What you're going to want to do is merge them. So floor plate to floor plate. And that gives you one list with all of the floor plates. You need to probably simplify this. That's just good practice, because whenever you merge two lists, they're probably going to have slightly different structures, and that's going to mess it up a bit. Do the exact same thing for subdivisions. Circulation areas. And the voids. So now that gives you a list of all of the inputs in their correct branches and at the correct levels. So in the next exercise, what we're going to do is cut these according to the setbacks, since you can notice that I specified many more levels than can be built. So given all of these instructions, as well as other kind of 3D voids and 3D forms, we can create the final set of floor plates to be analyzed.